Hello, Crafty Graphers. Tonight, I want to present version 1.25. So let's get started. First off, we're going to go ahead and open a image or a file here. We'll use the Apple file for our demonstration tonight. So first thing is we've made a few changes to two different tools. The first tool is the text tool, and basically we just changed the font so you can actually see what the font looks like here. It's kind of cool. And the second change is under the hand tool, we had a thing called selective mode. What selective mode is, let's say we wanted to crop just the leaf, right? Well, we're going to have the white area and the red areas. We don't want that. Click selective mode and simply choose areas you don't want. Zoom in a little more here. And drag until it's all grayed out. You can see it's turning gray. So we're going to go ahead and do that. And it's kind of a smart tool where it won't go over, it only goes with the color you initially clicked on. And then let's get rid of this. And then let's do the white. The white's a little harder to see. And in fact, let's zoom in a little more, or actually zoom out. If you zoom out, it turns gray. So then we can do that, and you can see it's kind of smooth. And there's no grids. And looks good. So once you're ready, push enter, and now you have a cropped leaf. Place it anywhere you want. Go get rid of that though. Alright, so now for the big thing. We've made some major changes to the PDF. So first thing you would notice is the layout's really different. We put the stuff over here for the PDF, and you'll see that we have the single crochet, C2C, TSS, and fillet still, but we also add a bobble. Three different bobbles actually. So first thing you notice is the fillet, and these two down here are they're grayed out. Well, there's certain reasons for that. I'll get to that in a bit. So bobble full makes the whole PDF is full of bobble. It goes single crochet, bobble, all the way for all the colors. Bobble solid color is a one-colored graph. Well, the graph's two colors, but it prints in one color, like fillet. And then bobble with single crochet lets you choose certain bobble points. So first off, we have to create a stitch, or a secondary stitch for that. Let's go ahead and cancel this. So let's say we wanted the leaf to pop out. Simply right-click on the colors you want to be bobble, and you will get this double marker on it. It's now a double crochet stitch. So if I went to export PDF, you can see this popped up now. And now it says that it's probably a good graph. You can export this, it'll be single crochet with a bobble crocheted stem, or a leaf. The same goes for fillet and the other bobble form, but you need a two-color graph. So let's go ahead and do that real fast. I have one right here, I believe. Oh, that's not it. Hold on. I think it's just called star. Okay, black and white, very simple. So let's say we want to make the white solid, or for fillet it'd be solid. So double crochet stitch is basically the double crochet stitch. So for fillet, it'd be the solid or the closed, and bobble will be the bobble stitch. So now if we go to export PDF, PDF, we can now export all these forms actually. So we can do fillet. In addition, you will also know that we have textual written and visual written. Visual written is a cell, it's like the Excel type graph. Now I'll show you that in a moment. The other thing is, you can now choose a start direction, the start side of the graph, so bottom, top, right, left, and then direction, right to left or left to right. I actually want to show you the colored form, but I want to do the apple. It's a better looking graph. Let's go here, let's go ahead and export. Sorry about that. Let's do bobble full. Actually, no. Let's do the stem where it's popping out. PDF, let's choose the bobble, single crochet. We got the textual written and the visual written. Let's go ahead and export this. And that's going to the desktop. And let's have a look. So this is all familiar to you right here. And it's not loading because it's a very dense graph. But here you have your single crochet, you have your written. A lot of pages, it's a big graph. And then you will have your colored version. So these are white cells, 301 across. And this is your guide up here. It tells you the single crochet versus single crochet plus 5 double crochet stitch. So you can see you got your white and your reds. Let's go down. Let's get to those double crochet stitches. That's going to be the green ones. I guess you can see, they have that extra border on them, so you know it's a double crochet by just looking at it. So that's that new feature we have added. And the last thing you may have noticed is we have upload and we have a club hub. This is for our graph swap feature. Graph swap. So you will be able to, if you want, if you join, you could basically upload graphs strictly to Graph Swap. And what that is a website where your graphs will go on here and people can potentially find a graph they want. Here's the apple again. They could choose the format they want to do it in. They essentially create a project and it will look like this. Now actually, let's do that's CTC. Let's do one that's a little more, let's choose a more interesting graph, actually. I have a few I uploaded. So something like this. Let's go ahead and do crochet. We're going to start it. And as you can see down here, it tells you all your information and stitch information and the rows and all that. Once you start it, you click resume. And this will feed you, basically kind of the cell, Excel version, the graph, line by line, or row by row, actually. And you just click to move forward. And it saves your progress. Let's choose a Bobble version. And the first row for a Bobble is single crochet. And the next row will have, this is a full Bobble, by the way. So this will have the single crochet plus the 5 double crochet stitches. And you can see they have that double border. And then you finish off with your single crochet stitch. And then you have your single crochet row again. So it's very simple, very easy to follow. As a grapher, you would always have access to your graphs, but you have to have membership to have access to other people's graphs. And you get two WIPs a day to work on. So, and you can simply just hover over your WIP and click resume and it goes right to it. So, those who are interested in graph swap, please let me know. Each person that works on your graph per day would generate you 12 cents. It will add up once there's a lot of members. So, please let me know. And thank you. PM me. Thank you.